today I'm out with my brother Walker, and we're doing a little creek fishing. We drove the truck up, hiked about, I don't know, maybe 10 minutes, and we're just gonna hit these tiny little pools. But what's fun about fishing these little creeks is it's very challenging because there's so much growth and down timber, and it's really steep on the sides. And another challenge is the water is so clear, the fish see you. So if you're just walking up on them, you'll spook them. So you gotta kind of spot and stalk fish. When you fish this way, you can expect a lot of snags. So we're prepared with some backup swivels and hooks. But we're gonna sneak up to this hole. I'm gonna let Walker get the first cast and see if we can't snag a nice trout out of this mountain creek.
They're all over in there.
Is there a lot?
Yeah.
Okay, so we got the fish spotted. Oh yeah, I could see some. You guys probably won't see because of the glare, but there is a bunch of fish swimming around right there.
I'm trying to get a little
closer. Yeah, you gotta get low and get, you're gonna have to stand in those willows or those rocks on the dam.
This is like spot and stalk fishing.
There we go. Oh, he's coming for it. Oh man, they followed it all the way. There was three fish following it all the way to the little dam right there. Yeah, there's a bunch of them. Okay, Walker says this is it. Oh! Oh yeah, fish on! Yeah! Fish on! Look how pretty these small creek fish are. That is so cool.
That is so awesome, man.
Nice cast.
Those blue spots.
Yep.
That's so beautiful.
Oh yeah. Hook up!
Yeah, buddy!
Oh, he's fighting like a marlin. Yes.
Man, we'd be eating good. Nice little trout. Pretty little guys.
Those are awesome.
Yeah, how cool.
There we go for the release, dang it. There you go.
So light.
There you go. Oh, you got a follower. Fish on, fish on. Oh.
Just had to make the right cast.
Sweet. You want me to get him off?
Yeah, sure.
That's what? How many fish out of this hole?
Three or four?
Yeah, that's at least three fish out of this one hole. We're probably gonna give it another couple casts and move upstream. There's some pools up there. It's gonna be hard to get to, but we'll find a way.
Okay.
That was cool, dude.
Little ferret thing.
Looks like somebody's pet. You would totally take it, dude. See ya.
Hey, look how cool this is.
Hey, buddy. See ya. I want to pet him.
We have an animal.
He's filming you.
Oh my gosh.
No.
He scares me, dude.
So I'll try this at home. Come and get it.
Come here.
Oh. Gosh! Got me!
And
he drew blood.
Really? Dude.
That's my own fault.
I want to watch that ASAP.
We tried some other spots and struggling. These fishing holes just aren't big enough to really fish effectively. So we came back to our number one spot. Gave it a couple hours break, so I think the fish are going to be back out and should be able to pull another couple of trout out of here.
Oh, there's one on it. Yeah. Sweet fish, man.
There he is, pretty, pretty fish. Just gonna let him go.
I'm gonna catch another one.
So fun, man. Walker's gonna go for another one. There seems to be quite a few about halfway up. Uh-oh. You're still in the game, you're still in the game. Oh, he's on it. Oh, yes! Two in a row. Woo! Man, these little fish are freaking out. All right, there's Walker's fish. Pretty little trout. These guys are small, but they're a lot of fun to catch. There he goes. Back home.
People at home, people at home. We've got a raindrop on the lens. Is that better? Maybe a little bit. Guys, this right now is not the greatest weather to be trying to be out on your back deck smoking some food with your Camp Chef Smoke Pro. But if you are attempting to use the Camp Chef Smoke Pro in any weather, it's a good day. Check this out. I know this goes against everything I believe, but check this out.
Nothing but veggies.
Nothing but veggies. I'm doing the veggies first. I've got to actually put some seasoning salt on this.
This is, I'm kind of trying to cook food. I'm not meal prepping by any means, but I am trying to cook food for the whole week. We are very busy up here at the Butler household, especially with the new baby. Brayley's running track, kids here, running kids everywhere. But so I'm doing a bunch of vegetables, and then I'm gonna do a bunch of food after this. But got to go hard with the seasoning salt. I did actually spread a little bit of balsamic vinegar all over this before I put it on, and I love balsamic vinegar. But that's what I'm doing. I'm trying to smoke these so I can get the meat on. That's what I'm doing. And I'm excited to show you guys what meat I'm smoking. It's very important meat.
And now for the meat. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at this. Look at that. Guys, this is, that's actually two steaks from a moose that my good friend Shane shot. But the other stuff is whitetail backstraps from Texas, from the deer that me and my dad shot. And this is from the pig that I shot down in Texas. So this is marinating in just some like zesty Italian dressing. The red meat is marinating in soy sauce, Worcestershire sauce, and a little bit of water. And we're getting ready to throw it on the Camp Chef. I'm super stoked. The vegetables are almost done. Just pulled all the vegetables off. We're gonna throw this pork on first. And I can't really tell you guys what the cuts are. They're all just little chunks like that. It was all cut up and packaged and froze and then sent to us after we left. But they look like maybe like some of the rib meat. I don't know. But just wanted to show you right now when I'm working with smaller pieces of meat, I'll throw the jerky tray on the Camp Chef so nothing's falling it down. And I'm just going to spread this stuff out.
and we're gonna cook it up real fast. I turned it one time, and it's looking pretty close to being done. I'd say if you want to be smart with pork, definitely make sure you're cooking it to at least 180 degrees. A lot of people get nervous about trigonosis in bears, but I had read somewhere that trigonosis actually started in pigs and pork. So cook to 185 degrees. I love my red meat medium rare, which is more like 130, 135. All right, 120, 125, 130. Anyways, make sure your pork's done and your bear, but I just ate a piece and it is amazing. I'm gonna eat another piece. So if you guys have been watching our channel for a while, you guys know that we use Camp Chef exclusively because we believe in their products. I've honestly been using their products for over 20 years. The first deer hunt I ever went on, first deer camp I was ever at, we had a Camp Chef double burner, and I believe in their products. So if you guys want to cook with some of the best gear out there, go to campchef.com, use our code HUSH, H-U-S-H, at checkout on anything on their website, and you will get 20% off, plus free shipping on anything over $50. So we're always trying to pass on what we believe in, and we definitely believe in Camp Chef. And so if you guys want to save some money, use that code, and we're gonna finish this up, and we're gonna get eaten. Eating right. Got the Camp Chef going. Getting ready to shoot the bow. Fishing this morning. Ooh, salmon.
That looks good.
So, fly fishing during the day. Camp Chef in the evening. Shooting bows in the evening. It's my idea of a good weekend. Eric and I will be at Total Archery Challenge down in San Antonio, Texas. It's May 5th through the 7th. If you've never been, register, check it out. We'll put a link down below in the description box. But these events, if you've never been to them before, are a ton of fun. We've shot the snowboard one a bunch in Utah and then also Big Sky, Montana. But here is my new bow. Casey's is all about that pink. Eric is about the green, and I'm about that neon yellow. This is my my little ode to my hometown of Oregon and the ducks. Just like the other guys, I'm shooting the Pro Defiant. It's in the buckskin. It's 31 axle to axle. I've got the black gold Ascent sight. 3-pin slider with the micro adjust. I've shot black gold basically my entire life archery hunting, back when they were called Montana black gold a long time ago. I'm actually getting a new sight window though, and it's gonna be a 4-pin slider, so I'll go a 30, 40, 50, 60, and then we'll get the sight tape on there for the rest. But got the Hoyt carbon stabilizer, and then messing around with the new carbon quiver, one piece, it just pops right off. But just like the Casey and Eric 2 quad rest, pretty money, fall away. So there is the target. That's my dog. Say hi, Deuce. Hey, buddy. Anyways, I'm gonna shoot some arrows through that bad boy.
Bullseye.
You're getting a new release soon. Playing around with that whole back tension release just to try to get more consistent, better form. But in the meantime, just rocking the old school one that I shot for a long time. It's a Scott of some sort. You follow a guy named Dan Evans Archery. I enjoy following along his hunts. He's a really good archer. He's like a designer, different kinds of rests and sights and stuff. But his tip that I just stuck with me for any of you guys that are new to archery was,
once you get your bull pulled back and you're anchored, level, settle, and then follow through on your shot. So level that bubble, settle your pin on your target, and then after you pull through on your release, just follow through. Watch the arrow hit the target through your little peep sight right there. Super good advice, and I try to always remember that before I shoot. Definitely helped me out. Oh man, let's go check it out. Do you see, do you approve? Do you approve? Huh? What do you think? Oh, pretty happy with that group. Those three in particular. Oh my gosh. Dang dog, freaking dog. Anyways, back to the program here. Those three are money. All are within the kill zone. It's just 30 yards right now. Like I said, I don't have my sight slider window, sight tape or whatever set up yet, but we should have that soon. I know it's been ordered by Wild Arrow Archery, just waiting for it to come in. So in the meantime, we'll just keep practicing at 30 yards. Working on form, repetition. That one's stuck. Good. Anyways, hope you guys are getting out and shooting. Casey, Eric. I know Casey's been shooting that beautifully sexy pink bow of his. What about you, EC? I think you're too busy just looking for sheds, man. Better get that bow out, son. We're gonna be at Total Archery Challenge in San Antonio in no time flat. Hate to get you embarrassed out there, you know?
Good afternoon, folks. It's a nice, well, it's sunny now, but it's been raining all day. It's calling for rain for like the next two or three days out here. But if you guys watch the shed hunting video we did with Chad and Ryan and Bridget, look who just showed up with the match of the Big Seven.
What up?
Ryan went up there and found it. So we found this side up there, and then a rainstorm hit us and we were all kind of tuckered out and ready to go eat hamburgers.
No packs.
Yeah, we didn't have our backpacks, food, or water, so we decided to bounce. We probably should have stayed and looked for the other side, but we didn't.
So I walked by it within 20 feet. Like, all I had to do was walk around one little point.
And you'd have found it?
20 feet. But, you know, it was easy to find once I went back up. We kind of knew right where it was at.
I know. I had a feeling that it was higher. Remember how I was like, I just feel like it's higher than we are?
Yeah.
And you had a feeling like it was in that, like, right there. And I didn't want to believe it was in that thick crap, but it was just on the other side of it.
Yeah, it was kind of out in the open.
So he's kind of a 6-point frame, matching kickers. This point somewhat would have, you know, been up there a little bit.
Maybe could have counted.
And a devil's tine. Yeah. So that's cool.
And I bet that's an inch too.
Yeah.
Regardless. I mean, he's not a monster bull.
He's not giant, but man, these things are dense. Like,
score wise, he's not gonna be like, yeah, look at those.
Yeah, look how heavy that is. Right there on both of them. I mean, there's some major palmation there.
That's sweet.
And these horns, like, it's funny because some antlers feel like they're honeycomb. Like, they look big and heavy and you pick them up and there's no weight to them. Yeah. These guys are dense, super heavy. So we're out here just doing some pictures. But I wanted to give you guys a little bit of an update. The day that this video aired, the day that this video went live, you found it, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're like, yeah, you can save it for your video. I'm like, dude, that thing's scheduled to launch today.
It's launching in an hour.
So, there he is, guys. Super cool 7.
Here, let me hold it up.
Yeah, hold that sucker up together.
I'll crouch down.
There we go. Oh, man, he's cool. And this, the unit he came off, this probably is considered a shooter for there, huh?
Oh, this is probably one of the best bulls on that unit. not, I mean, it used to be a great unit, but nowadays, this would be a killer bull. Most bulls come off that unit are 3.5, 4.5 years old, and this bull's probably 6.5.
Hmm.
So you saw his pictures from last year.
Yeah, he was an inline 7 last year, huh?
Yeah.
It's so funny how many people have sent us pictures and video of this bull this year packing this same set.
Well, he hung out in my backyard.
Yeah, he was close to Ryan's.
Yeah.
Anyway, super sweet bull. It's kind of cool to see him together. We pretty much knew he was an inline 7 on the other side. But Ryan went up there and Billy goated up there. It's not an easy hike either. It's so steep. But they're sweet. There you go, guys.
You good?